Morning students, now we have to discuss about the fundamentals of data networks. So we have to discuss the introduction about networks, how it will be connected and how it is works, what are the basic items we have to use in the networks. So it will be containing the data communications, networks, internet, protocols and protocol standards. So introduction, data communication and networking. So data communication means change the way we do business and the way we live. Business decisions have to be made more quickly. Decisions depends on immediate access to accurate information. Business today rely on computer networks and internet networks. Before we get hooked up to know about what are the needed to connect the network, how network is operate, what are the types of technologies are available, which design best fills which set of needs. So development of the PC changes a lot in business, industries, science and education. Similar revolution is occurring in data communication and networking. So technologies advances are making it possible for communication links to carry more and faster signals. Services are evolving to allow the use of this expanded capacity. For example, we have using telephone services in the network examples. We have use as well as extended to have conference calling, call waiting, voicemail, caller ID. These are also used in this quarantine period. Communication. Communication means sharing of information, local, face to face or remote, over a distance cover the peoples. Telecommunication. So telecommunication, it will be sharing the information using the telephone device. Telephone, telegraph and television. So it means communication at a distance. Tele is a Greek for data. Data communication means it will be the data refers the information presented in any form. So in the form agreed by the two parties or creating the parties or using the parties. Data communication. So data communication is the exchange of data between two devices via some form of transmission media. For example, wire cables. Communication system made up a combination of hardware and software. Effectiveness of data communication system depends on delivery, accuracy, timelines, jitter. So these are the basic factors to cover the effectiveness of data communication. So first one is the delivery. Delivery means the system must deliver data to correct destination. Data received by the intended user only. The next effectiveness is accuracy. Accuracy is the system must deliver data accurately. No changes in that original data. Data changed or uncorrected is unusable. So third factor is the timelines. Timelines is the system must deliver data in timely manner. Data arrived late or useless. In the same order, video and audio and without delay. Real-time transmissions are examples for without delay. So last one factor is effectiveness of data communication is jitter. Jitter, variations in the packet arrival time, uneven quality in the video is the result. So uneven quality means the depending upon your data as well as the video or as well as the audio. So here is the examples for data communication, how throughout the world it will be covered by the communication. So next one is the components of data, means data network. Data communication system made up of five components. So the five components are message, sender, receiver, medium, and the last one is the full effectiveness of the data components. Sender. So sender is the device that sends the data message to the receiver. So sender is the computer or it's the workstation or it may be the telephone handset and video cameras. So next one is the receiver. Receiver is the second main component. the device that receives the message. It will be the computer, or it will be the workstation, telephone, handset, and the televisions. Okay, the third component is the message. So the message is very important component to connect the sender and receiver, the information or data to be communicated. So it will be the message consists of text, numbers, pictures, audio or video. So fourth component is the medium component. Medium is the physical path by which a message travels from sender to receiver. Here is the examples for medium: twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cables and the radio waves. Here the pictures are shown, the twisted pair, coaxial, fiber optic, radio waves. It is mainly used for the data communications in the network. The last important component is protocol, a set of rules that govern data communications, an agreement between the communicating devices. Devices may be connected but not communicating. So that is, we have no protocols. Arabic speaker with Japanese speaker. It will be know about Arabic speaker, Japanese, Japanese speaker, Arabic. So we have here the protocol will be used for the Arabic and Japanese speaker. So data representation. So data representation is the form of text, numbers, images, audios and videos. So text is the sequence of bits or zeros and ones. Different sets of patterns to represent text symbols. Each set is called code. ASCII code we have used in the text. 7 bits of ASCII codes are used. 128 basic symbols we have used. Common coding systems today we have used Unicode systems. Unicode system uses 32 bits to represent a symbol or character in any language. So for example, the range is bracketly given here, Unicode range. So next important data representation is numbers. So number represents the bit patterns. The number is directly converted to a binary number. So images represented by the bit patterns, a matrix of pixels. So resolution is the size of the pixels. It will be clarity of the image. High resolution, more memory is needed. Each pixels assigned a bit pattern. One bit pattern we have used black and white colors, that is dot images we have used in the color images. It will be black and white is one bit pattern. 2-bit patterns are 4 levels of gray levels, that is 00, 01, 10, 11. So next level is RGB, that is we have used in the color images. Next, audio. Audio is the continuous, not discrete data. So change to digital signals, that is will be converted analog to digital signals. Video. Recording or broadcasting of picture or movie, change to digital signal. So next important concept in network is data flow. So data flow is the communication between two devices. Can be used in the form of simplex, half duplex, full duplex. So the first method is simplex method. One way street. It is, imagine we have to use the simplexes one way street. The communication is unidirectional. Only one device on a link can transmit. The other link can only receive. Use the entire capacity of the channel to send the data. Examples, keyboard, monitors. Students, we have used the keyboard. We have to press the A or any numbers. It will be transmitted to the CPU. So it is unidirectional. It is called as one-way street. Here the picture is shown, that mainframe data will be pressed. It will be directed to the monitor. So next method is half duplex. One LAN with two directional traffics. Each station can both transmit and receive, but not at the same time. When one device is sending, the other can only receive it, and vice versa. The entire capacity of channel is taken over by the transmitting device. Examples, walkie-talkies. Here the picture shows the examples of half duplex, one LAN with two directional traffics. Station, one is sending the data using the direction date at time 1. The station 2, it will be sending the data in the next directions. Okay. Using walkie-talkies. Walkie-talkies, students, we have using in many films and or you have using in the police in your street. Somewhat messages you have to talk and end with over. Okay, some of the person you have to talk and end over. The another person can talk in this media. So the common transmission path sharing the two persons. Next method is full duplex. Full duplex is the two-way street. Both stations can transmit and receive at same time. Or at the same time, we can using the both the stations 1 and 2 send the data. One is the sending and another one is the receiving. Another station is one is the sending and another is the receiving. Signals going in either direction sharing the capacity of the link. Sharing can occur in two ways. Link has two physically separate transmission paths. Only for sending and another for receiving. The capacity of the channel is divided between the signals traveling in the both directions. Examples, telephone network. So exercise. So here one of the examples we have given. Station 1 and 2, we have sending the data. What method we have used? So here is the example, full duplex method we have used in this examples. So next, network. So network is the main concept we have used in this day-to-day life. So, network is a set of devices or nodes connected by the communication links. Node is a computer or a printer or a monitor or a central processing unit, you have to CPU or a phone or anything you have used in that node. Distributed processing. Most networks used in distributed processing. Task is divided among the multiple computers instead of one single large computers. So, network criteria. Network must be meet a certain number of criteria. The most important of network criteria are performance, reliability, security. So, we have discussed the first parameter, performance. So, network performance depending upon the transmitting time and response time. So, transmitting time, the amount of time required for a message to travel from one device to another. Response time. So, it will be the elapsed time between an inquiry and a response. So, that is, we have posting a one command to the opponent. The opponent will be responding to or acknowledging to me. It will be the time elapsed time. So, elapsed time between an inquiry and a response. So, next performance metric is performance depends on one number of users. That is, number of users means large number of slow response time. So, two means type of transmission media. It will be depending upon the performance. Fiber optic cabling faster than the other cables. So, it will be faster communication, it will be made by the network. So, third one is the capability of the connected hardware. So, affect both the speed and capacity of transmissions. Fourth one is the efficiency of the software. Process the data at the sender and receiver and intermediate affects network performance. So, performance is evaluated by two contradictory networking metrics. First one is the throughput. Throughput is high. High means a measure of how fast we can actually send the data through a network. Delay, it will be low. Low means the network processing is low. So, next factor is reliability. So, reliability is measured by frequency of failure, recovery time of network after a failure, network robustness in a catastrophic, that is protected by good backup network systems. So, these are also the basic factors, that is basic measurement. Readed by the reliability of the networks. So, first we have to discuss the performance. So, next we have to discuss the measurement. That is, measurement we have used in the transmission time. So, performance, reliability, security. So, performance, throughput and delay. Second one, reliability. So, frequency of failure, recovery time of network and network robustness. These are also the measurement. Third one is security. So, security is protecting data from unauthorized access. Protecting data from damage or development. implementing policies and procedures for recovering from breaches and data losses. That is recovery plan we have used. So next one is the physical structure of network. These are also the important concept of network, physical structure. So how the type of network can be connected. So network, two or more devices connected through a link. Link, communication path that refers the data from one device to another device. Two devices must be connected in some way to the same link at the same time. Two possible types we have used. One is the point-to-point communication. Second one is the multi-point communication. So point-to-point communication, dedicated link between two devices. The entire capacity of the link is reserved for transmission between those two devices. Use an actual length of wire or cable. Here is the point-to-point communication, station 1 to station 2. You are using the only one link. So next is the point-to-point. Other options such as microwave or satellite is possible to connect the point-to-point communication. Example, television remote control systems. Next one is the multi-point communication. It will be called as the multi-drop. More than two devices share a link. Capacity is shared. Channel is shared either spatially or temporally. Spatially shared if devices use a link at the same time. Time share if users must take turns. It's called as a time sharing system. Here the picture for example is for the multi-point communication. Mainframe computers connected the three stations. The link will be shared by the three stations. Next one is important concept in network is topology. So topology, the way of network laid out in physically. Two or more links forms a topology. The topology of network is the geometric representation of relationship of all the links and linking devices called nodes to one to another nodes. Four topologies we have used in the basic level: mesh topology, star topology, bus topology and ring topology. Here topology, four types it will be classified: mesh, star, bus and ring. First topology is mesh topology. Every link is dedicated point-to-point link. The term dedicated means that the link carries traffic only between the two devices. It will be connecting the mesh topology. So mesh, to link n devices, fully connected mesh has n into n minus 1 by 2 physical channels we have used in the full duplex method of data flow. Every device on the network must have n minus 1 ports. Here is the example. The systems are known. Here internal it will be connected by the mesh topology. So one of the examples we have using the mesh topology. Suppose we have 8 devices in the mesh. It will be has the link n into n minus 1 by 2 links. So n is the 8. So number of links 8 into 8 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 28. So number of ports per devices is n minus 1. 8 minus 1 is 7. So number of port is 7, number of link is 28, so number of devices is 8. Mesh topology advantages. Each connection carry its own data load, no traffic problems. A mesh topology is robust. Privacy or security, it will be the main advantage for mesh topology. Fault identification and fault isolation. So mesh topology disadvantages: big amount of cabling, big number of I/O ports, installation and reconnections are difficult. Sheer bulk of the wiring can be greater than the available space. Hardware connect to each I/O would be expensive. These are also the disadvantages of mesh topology. So mesh topology is implemented in a limited fashion of networking we have used in the applications. Examples, as a backbone of hybrid network. Next topology is star topology. So star topology we have used in all education institutions. It will be the hierarchical connections. Star, duplicated point to point, a central controller hub is connecting to the star topology. No direct traffic between the devices. The control act as an exchange. So star topology, using the advantages, less expensive than mesh topology. One link plus one port per device. Easy to install and reconfigure the star topology to another topology. Less cabling. We have using the minimum number of cabling we have using the or implementing the star topology. Additions, moves and deletions are required one connection. It means that we have to use one node, we have to add, it will be easy. One node, it will be moved to the another network, it will be easy. Deletion, one node can be deleted from the entire network, it will be easy to implement. Robustness, one fail does not affect the others. If it is one node is failure node in the group, it will be removed from that. So it not affect the others node. Easy fault identification and fault isolation, it will be the main advantages for the star topology. Next one is the disadvantages. Dependency of the whole topology on one single point is called hub. More cabling than other topologies is called ring or bus. Used in LAN. So bus topology, that is star topology, is mainly used in LAN, that is local area network. So next important concept is bus topology. This multi-point topology. One long cable acts as a backbone. Used in the design of earlier LANs and Ethernet LANs. So bus nodes are connected to the cable by drop lines and tapes. Single travels along the backbone and some of its energy is transformed to heat. Limit number of taps and the distance between the taps used in the bus topology. So bus topology advantages, ease of installation, less cables than mentioned star topology. Disadvantages, difficult to reconnect and fault isolation. That is, we have using the limited number of taps, so we have to identify the fault. So it will be difficult in the bus topology. Adding a new device requires modifications of backbone. Fault or break stops all transmission. The damaged area reflects single signals back in the directions of the origins, creating noise in both directions. Ring topology is another important concept for topology. Ring. Each device has dedicated point-to-point connection with only the two devices on either side of it. A signal is passed along at the ring in one direction from the device to device until it reaches its destination. Each device incorporates a repeaters. Here are the examples. So each stations can connect with the repeaters. The repeaters are connected by the network cables. So ring advantages, easy to install and reconfigure, connect to immediate neighbors, move to connections for any moving, that is addition or deletion, easy to fault isolation. Disadvantages, unidirectional can be made upon the ring topology. One broken device can disable the entire network. This weakness can be solved by using a dual ring or a switch cable of closing of the break. So next important concept is hybrid topology. Examples, having a main star topology with each branch connecting several stations in the bus topology. Here bus and star is combined by another topology. It's called as hybrid topology. So each bus is connected by the hub. It will be called a star. Okay. Next, categories of networks. Network category depends on its size. Two primary categories we have used, LAN, WAN. LAN covers less than 2 miles of or 2 kilometers of areas. WAN can be worldwide. MAN between LAN and WAN span the 10 kilometers of miles. Local area network LAN, privately owned by the institution. Links devices in the same office, building or campus. Simple LAN, 2 PCs and 1 printer in home or office. It's called as LAN network. Size is limited to a few kilometers. Allow resources to be shared, hardware, software or data. So local area network. So it's an isolated LAN connecting 12 computers to a hub in a closet. So LAN is distinguished by size, transmission media, topology. Size, the number of OS or number of users or licensing restrictions. Transmission media, only one type of transmission media we have used by cable. Topology we have using bus topology, ring topology, star topology. Data rates. Data rates, LAN is covered by earlier stage 4 to 16 Mbps, that is megabits per second we have covered. today 100 to 1000 Mbps we have covered by the network. So wide area network provides a long distance transmission of data over large geographical areas. It will be the country, continent or the world wide web. Switched WANs, backbone of the internet. Switched WAN is the main backbone of the internet. Next one is the dial-up line of point-to-point WAN. Leased line from a telephone company we have used in the point-to-point WAN. Okay, here one of the examples we have used in the point-to-point WAN wide area network. First concept is switched WAN, second concept is point-to-point WAN. So size, here the end systems A and B, it will be connected by the switch WAN. All the end systems are connected by the switches. So point-to-point WAN, here is the one of the device we have used, the modem, point-to-point wide area network. So modem, it will be converted into modulator and demodulate. So that is modulate the signals, analog to digital, digital to analog. Metropolitan area networks, MAN, size between LAN and WAN, inside a town or a city. Examples, the part of telephone company network that can provide a high-speed DSL, digital subscriber link to customer. So two or more networks connected to the network. Switched WANs, it will be connected by the LAN, two types of LAN. So on the switched WAN, it will be connected by the switched WAN. Thank you, students.